Hello, everyone, and welcome back for my final three guests of today's show. I'm very happy to be joined by Artem, or two Artems, actually. So I'm going to call you Art. Art Yukhin, who is president and CEO of Artec 3D. Vlada Kovbasa, board member at LUkraine asbl. And another Artem, Artem Antonenko, board member also at LUkraine asbl. And we're going to talk about how businesses can help and continue to help to support charities. Of course, the whole world knows what's going on with Ukraine at the moment. And starting with you, Art, tell us about what you've been doing to work with Ukraine.
Thank you very much. If I may, I will start with a brief introduction of what Artec 3D is. We're a little bit unusual for Luxembourg because we are production, so we are producer of 3D technologies, so we design, produce and sell all over the world what is called 3D scanners. Many people get used to what 3D becoming a trendy word, so metaverse, 3D printers. We are producing 3D scanners, and what I'm saying, it's unusual because it's high-end electronics and optics that we produce here locally in Luxembourg and sell all over the world. So we sell it in all the countries, more than 60 countries, through our resellers, more than 150 of them, in Asia, Americas, Europe, everywhere, and to many industries. So basically, very simply, what 3D scanner is the device that you can use to make a digital clone, a digital duplicate with very high precision of anything, starting with very small, tiny things, to the very large buildings, vehicles, anything. So it's being used in many technologies. And today I will give some idea of what programs we do in Ukraine, because it's also interesting for Ukraine. So what else? First of all, of course, we're here to talk about this responsibility of the businesses. And when I say we businesses need to help Ukraine, it's even not that, because actually Ukraine is helping all of us right now, being on the front end and paying a very high price with blood and their lives. So they're helping us. And I think that's very important to keep attention of public, because it's very hard topic. It's difficult to keep attention on these terrible things, actually. But it's very important that everybody is in scope. It happens with the same people as we, just next door. So, that's why we started when the war started. And we are very multinational company. We have people from more than 24 countries, only employees. But as I said, we have 150 resellers all over the world. So we started with a simple donation to LUkraine. So we started with 30,000 euros. So, and then we encouraged our employees and we said, we will double your contribution. And it came about 50,000 euros in the first months. So, but it's important for anything. We in business, we all we love to speak about recurrent revenues. It's the same. It's the same here. It's important to do recurrent contributions because the war is not over, unfortunately. But even if magically somebody will stop Russia right now, today, so we have at least about 14 million people that had to leave their homes. Just think about it. So the scale is difficult to understand. 14 million of families of people who had to move. So it means 14 million broken lives. So that's why even if today the war stops, so a lot of contribution would be needed for a long time. So that's why we thought how we can help. So first of all, of course, we help as the industry leaders in 3D. So there are three areas, three projects, three initiatives that we're now doing in Ukraine. First of all, our scanners that are wireless 3D scanners and allow very fast to scan, to digitize both areas, artifacts. So they are being used by police and law enforcement all over the world. So, and when the war started, ICC, International Criminal Court, and the prosecutors of Ukraine and some other countries, they formed a JIT, Joint Investigation Team, to do a very important thing, to digitize the evidence of the war crimes that are happening right now. And the scale of the things that are happening there request for new technologies to be implemented. So we are working on this project to digitize the evidence. It can be destroyed things, cities, corpses, sorry, of people after the massacre that is happening there. And it's very important to digitize this evidence to be used then in investigation and to be used in a tribunal. So that's the first project. The second project, our scanners are widely used in medicine, in particular in prosthesis. So because even in the peaceful time, so there are people who lost their limbs, and then you don't want to give them the standardized replacement because it will hurt. So you want to give customized replacement. Usually it's quite expensive technology to do it. So we are working with Ukraine right now, with the government and with the different organizations that are interested, to set a pipeline where people, and now there are at least thousands of people, young people, children, senior people who lost their arms and legs, to get the access to this technology. It means somebody in the field on site will be scanning their body parts, and then the manufacturer will be additive manufacturer, for example, would be able to produce the prosthesis which fit them, and they will feel comfortable and they will feel less pain. So that's the second project with prosthesis. And the third project that we have in Ukraine is to save Ukrainian heritage, because unfortunately, up to now, there are tons of unique sculptures, unique heritage masterpieces that are already destroyed. So this is very important right now to duplicate, to digitize, and we donated scanners and technologies to do that. Unfortunately, we have partner who keep, and it's also very interesting, we have a partner that is a business, and they initially are from Kharkiv, but Kharkiv is totally destroyed, so they have to move, and now these 50 people, employees are spread it around Ukraine, but they keep working. And of course, they're supporting us, and we're supporting them in these three projects that I mentioned. So together with the government of Ukraine. So, and the last thing that we invented and that I want to share with other businesses is the model how we will continue to keep. So here I'm returning back to this recurrent model of contribution. So we decided that certain percentage of each scanner, this is our top model, Leo, sold all over the world, so we'll go to LUkraine. So at the moment, that's 1% of each scanner that we get. So we don't sell directly. So we sell through 150 resellers, as I said. And they would receive the invoice. They're receiving invoice right now. And then it would be a footnote saying that this sum of this invoice will go to help Ukraine. So, and then you, our reseller, is also invited to contribute. And then the matching investment of 1% will be this, and 2% will be this. So, and that's what we started to do. So we have an agreement with LUkraine, and we set a special account. So where all this contribution are coming and every month. And I think that this will help a lot.
Well, Art, you've given us an enormous example of all of the work there that you're doing with Artec 3D and everything that you've invested personally as a company to help support what's happening in Ukraine. Now, for our audience who may not know about LUkraine, could you explain to all of the listeners and the people present what LUkraine is?
Yes, of course. I guess that will be me. So LUkraine is ISBL, that is working in Luxembourg since 2014, since the first part of the war broke out and until it was quite a heated moment. Ukraine was working on humanitarian aid, and after that, mostly focusing on the culture representation of Ukrainians in Luxembourg, like participated in lots of different international bazaars, exhibitions, and other events to show Ukrainian culture that was oppressed for many years to other European nations. Since 24th of February, it's completely repurposed again to focus on the humanitarian help. And thanks to partners and donors like Artec 3D, we can keep helping, because there is no small help in such case. From a different small donations, we make a huge difference there.
And I know that you have, first of all, been in the news so much asking for very specific donations, and it's always been on the site about the specific donations that you need and all sorts of medical supplies that we don't normally have at home, but that you would need, or various, all sorts of different items that we could not guess. So Artem, from your point of view, what has been the greatest level of support, and what can companies do? I mean, Artec have shown, Art here, he's shown, you know, so much work that he has been continuously doing, and also used that word recurrent help, because we may have seen Ukraine drop slightly down in the news articles. We all know it's still ongoing. So what should we do as individuals and companies to continue to help?
Yeah, sure. First of all, you already did a lot, and we appreciate it. As a companies, you support us, and many businesses and companies in Luxembourg show that they are not, you know, indifferent to the Ukrainian destiny, and they provide us pretty good support, you know, so, and show a really high level of hospitality. So, and talking about the help, of course, we have several levels, you know, of help. Help with donations, like recurrent payment, because, you know, because of this money, of these things, we can really help. Yeah, we can check what at this current moment Ukrainian citizen need, because needs can be vary, you know, so from time to time. So for some period, for example, they don't have electricity because of these things, and we need to provide, you know, generators. Yeah, or they have issues with ambulance, and we have a project when we are sending ambulances to the Ukraine. So it can be different. And also here in Luxembourg, one place you also can help, because we have a lot of people who actually came to the Luxembourg now as refugees, yeah? But they are highly educated people. They worked in the very high positions in Ukraine, you know, so they have not only one high like graduates, you know, so they have different diplomas in different areas. And what we can do, yeah, I mean, what would be great if business can also consider them. We know this experience already in Europe, that and I saw in many, I would say, working sites, they put that, okay, Ukrainians, you have the highest priority for us now, you know, because it's also opportunity for the business. It's not only, okay, please hire, but this because they can hire really great talents, you know, so because these people, they, because of war, they can't work anymore on their like job, right? But they keep their level of the talent, so they can actually increase the, I would say, level of the talents in their companies.
So if we have businesses who could hire people, should they get in touch with you? Do you have a checklist of all of the Ukrainian refugees here?
Yeah, definitely. So it's actually one of our projects. I was not supposed to talk about this project, but we have the project Maria, which helping Ukrainians, you know, to find a job. So they create their CVs, because the way how we creating CV in Luxembourg a little bit different from Ukraine, yeah? And we need to teach them a bit. And we have this platform, and in this platform we even already did automatical matching, you know? So all employees or businesses who wants to hire Ukrainian just can contact us, and we will add their positions to our database. And in this way they can find really fast matches. So yeah, for sure.
And I think there's also some more examples that you've had of business connections with Ukraine. Would you like to tell us about that? I know with the government, for instance.
Yes, of course. For the businesses, I just wanted to add one thing to Artem's speech, how else businesses can help. It's not just through hiring or donating. There is also a lot of very high-tech businesses in Ukraine. Just partner with them. consider them as your next business partner, as your next vendor or supplier. Just look into that market. It's high tech. It's already on the level when we have to compete with US markets mostly because of the school ties. So it's something that can actually lift up your business. So what I wanted to mention initially that I've noticed recently that lots of Luxembourgish businesses think that like there is nothing we can do. We can donate, but there is nothing else. But one case from Ukraine that inspires me throughout the last 8 years is when a software, DIA, which is the first digital passport and the one-stop shop for all of the state services for Ukrainians. It started as an initiative of small businesses because they were struggling to run their businesses efficiently and react fast on the changing environment of the market with a lot of the bureaucracy around. So they started to negotiate with the municipalities first and started to make the deals that some of the services will be digitalized. And each of the municipality were driven by those small businesses who wanted this to happen. And when this is a massive speak out from people, the government listens. And this is just one example when a small initiative from a business to make their life easier made a huge revolution in the digital state services. So
it's a wonderful example. And so again, with you, Art, and all of the work that you've done, you've shown us what businesses, whatever their size, can actually do to support all of the people in Ukraine.
Yeah, I want also to add, because it's when we say Artec, again, this is 150 partners all over the world. And they're quite excited to help us. And we're very happy to work with LUkraine because it's very transparent, actually. And we get a report. We know that, for example, for the first donation that we did, we were able, I mean, LUkraine was able to buy a particular thing. It was ambulance vehicle and some other medical devices. So, and then now, so when we top up this donations next month, we hope to buy the next one. So it's becoming quite exciting for businesses when they see where their donation goes. They know it's not just some abstract thing. They know in particular what they're doing. And that's why I invite all other businesses to join again. So in our case, we donate 1% from each scanner plus our resellers donate. It's not a big thing. Very often when our resellers are selling the product to the customer, they make 10% discount. So if you do 1% or 2% discount for sending them to Ukraine, it's not much. But having this sustainable recurrent contribution will save a lot of lives. So it's and you will see the result. You will see the ambulance machines or other things that are helping people and saving lives.
Well, it's wonderful that you have that feedback as well about where your money is actually going. Final word to you both. We're sitting here at ICT Spring, so many wonderful businesses and minds around us. If you have a call to action, what would you suggest?
Yeah, so a couple words about the most successful, one of the most successful collaboration at the moment between us and Luxembourg business, right? So it's Doctena project, and we have a really great collaboration. And I mean,
just to underline that, that's Doctena.
Doctena.
Yes.
Doctena.
Which we all know in Luxembourg.
Yeah,
Doctena.
Yeah. I think yes, more or less, right? So we are using this time to time here. So and thanks to the founder and the CEO Alan, because he provided us great support. So we started to think about this from very beginning about the psychological help, because one of our first project was accommodation of the refugees. And when we talk to them, you know, so they live in their houses and not like, it's not about just to take some stuff with them. Some of them left in sleepers, you know, and it was February. So they were shocked and they were super frustrated. And of course they need psychological help. Yeah. But one of the main issues those time was that they're not speaking foreign languages. and we need to have native speakers for them. So it means that we need to solve several issues. First of all, we need to be able to have kind of remote consultations, right? So, and then we need to have a platform which people can trust. Yeah, so because such kind of stuff, you can go just, I don't know, in Messenger and get the psychological consultation, right? So you need to have a platform which can trust. And so one of our former employee suggested that, okay, we can contact Doc Tena, right? So, and we wrote to the Alan and he answered that they were thinking for some time how to help Ukraine. Yeah, but they haven't found a way at those time. And then we told that, okay, so let's create the psychological help project together. And I've created the list of the like user stories, you know, what have to be done. And they did everything. They really support us and we continue collaboration with them. They provided us 15, access for the 15 doctors. And now soon, I mean, from day to day, Doctena will be Ukrainian as well. So we are adding Ukrainian language for people to easy to orient. So it's great support and thanks to Doctena for this.
That's an absolute fantastic success story there from Doctena with such needed services. A final word to you.
Yes, yes. Address any businesses here that think that they can make the difference and that they want to make the difference. We have a booth with Artec 3D. They kindly allowed us to piggyback a bit on their wonderful scanning machine. So our representatives are constantly there. And if you think that you want to help and you can help, but you don't know how just yet, go find us and we will help to look at your specific technology, at your business, at what you can do, and we will find a way. Trust me.
I'm sure you will. You're a very tenacious, strong-willed nation for sure. And I think the whole world has seen that and the world stands with you. Thank you all so much for your time. Thank you. If you want to speak to LUkraine, you can go over to the booth. If you ask for an Art or an Artem, I'm sure you'll find somebody here to do with LUkraine or also Artec 3D. Thank you so much for all the work you're doing with LUkraine. Thank you all for watching, for listening, and we'll be back at the same time again tomorrow noon till 2. I'll be back with you with another wonderful array of the guests who are making up ICT Spring here 2022. Thank you.